Tracheal stenosis is a medical condition characterized by narrowing of the trachea, which is the airway that connects the larynx to the lungs. This narrowing can lead to difficulty breathing and can be caused by a variety of factors. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. The trachea, normally a flexible tube-like structure, can become constricted due to various reasons, leading to reduced air passage that can negatively affect breathing. The causes of tracheal stenosis are broadly characterized into two types: congenital, which is presented at birth, and acquired. Congenital tracheal stenosis is less common and occurs as a result of a developmental anomaly during fetal growth, leading to a narrow trachea at birth. Acquired tracheal stenosis, on the other hand, is more common and arises from factors such as prolonged intubation, infections, trauma, or inflammatory conditions like Wegener's granulomatosis. In some cases, external compression due to tumors or thyroid enlargement can also cause tracheal stenosis. The symptoms of tracheal stenosis usually develop gradually and can vary in severity based on the degree of narrowing. Common symptoms include shortness of breath, especially during physical activity, wheezing, coughing, stridor, and frequent respiratory infections. In severe cases, it can lead to significant breathing difficulties, requiring immediate medical attention. Diagnosis of tracheal stenosis typically involves a combination of a patient's medical history, physical examination, and specialized tests. Imaging techniques such as chest x-rays, CT scans, and MRI can help visualize the tracheal structure. However, the most definitive diagnostic tool is a bronchoscopy, where a flexible tube with a camera is inserted through the nose or mouth to directly visualize the inside of the trachea. Treatment for tracheal stenosis depends on the underlying cause, the severity of the stenosis, and the patient's overall health. In mild cases, monitoring and medical management might be sufficient, while more severe cases often require surgical intervention. The surgical options include tracheal resection and reconstruction, where the narrowed section of the trachea is removed and the remaining ends are reconnected, and tracheal dilation, where the trachea is mechanically widened using balloons or rigid dilators. In some cases, stent placement may be necessary to keep the trachea open. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.